Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX launched their first multiple payloads of 2023 with the Transporter 6 mission.
One. And lift off.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1061, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
We are attempting to recover this booster for the 15th time today, targeting this landing at Landing Zone 1. We've got just one more burn, which is the landing burn on the first stage. We'll ignite just a single center Merlin engine. That'll happen just before touchdown.
Stage 1 transonic.
On the right-hand side of your screen, we've got a ground view of Stage 1. You can see the center engine
stage
has
one
ignited.
Landing burn.
We'll expect to see the four
stage
landing legs deployed
for
a soft touchdown at Landing Zone 1. Now, during this, we'll also hear a call out of second engine cutoff on the second stage.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Seco.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
So landing is complete. We also heard a call out there for Seco.
Nominal parking orbit.
Seco is second engine cutoff number 1. We just heard a call out as well for nominal parking orbit. And with that, we have landed the Falcon 9. It's our 161st landing of an orbital class rocket. This booster's 15th.
Related to this launch, SpaceX posted a tweet. They said Falcon 9 launches SpaceX's 6th dedicated smallsat rideshare mission, completing our 200th successful launch. SpaceX's second launch of 2023 should be a Starlink mission. The Starlink 24 mission is currently scheduled for Monday, January 9th at 2:54 a.m. UTC or Sunday 8th at 9:54 p.m. EST. In addition to that, we could actually see the third launch of 2023 on Monday as well. The OneWeb 16 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 9th at 4:45 a.m. UTC or Sunday 8th at 11:45 p.m. EST. We found out last video about NASA talking with SpaceX about the possibility of helping with returning the stranded cosmonauts. There was an article posted with information about possibilities. It says, as NASA and Roscosmos determine what to do about the Soyuz MS-22 situation, one potential option is using SpaceX's Crew Dragon Endurance to bring all 7 ISS crew members home. Crew Dragon actually is designed for 7 people, but NASA needs only 4 seats, so that is the number in Endurance right now. NASA is asking SpaceX what it would take to accommodate the 3 who arrived on Soyuz MS-22 as well. Unfortunately, we still have no content from Starbase to take a look at, but we might be able to expect some testing this week. As we saw last video, there is a possible closure for this week with Friday 6th and also next week on Monday 9th. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.